It's night in the big city. Somewhere, a car alarm goes off. A woman walks barefoot, her high heels in her handbag. It's Theme Time Radio Hour with your host, Bob Dylan.
Time once again for Theme Time Radio Hour. And tonight, we're going to head out to the field of dreams, schemes, and themes, the ever-widening diamond, to take a look at the national pastime, baseball. Nellie Kelly loved baseball games, knew the players, knew all their names. You could see her every day shouting hurrah when they play. Her boyfriend by the name of Joe said, "To Coney Island, dear, let's go." Then Nellie started to fret and pout, and to him I heard her shout, "Take me out to the ball game, take me out with the crowd, buy me some peanuts and Cracker Jacks. I don't care if I never get back, let me root, root, root for the home team. If they don't win, it's a shame, for it's 1, 2, 3 strikes, you're out at the old ball game." Nellie Kelly was sure some fan. She could root just like any man. Told the umpire he was wrong, all along good and strong. When the score was just 2-2, Nellie Kelly knew what to do. Just to cheer up the boys she knew, she made the game sing this song. And I just sung it for ya.
Take me out to the ball game. Take me out to the crowd. Buy me some peanuts and Cracker Jack. I don't care if I never get back with a root, root, root for the home team. If they don't win, it's a shame, for it's 1, 2, 3 strikes, you're out at the old ball game.
Play ball!
Stepping up to the batter's box first, we've got Miss Mabel Scott. She played for a short while with the Jimmy Lunsford Orchestra and was a regular at the Club Alabama in Los Angeles. She sang with a group led by Lorenzo Flannoy. In the early 50s, she moved over to King Records, where she sang this song about the greatest game on earth, Mabel Scott, Baseball Boogie.
If I pitch, can you catch? Will you hold the ball? When you step to the plate, will you swing and fall? If you play, you gotta know how it's done. Can you catch, can you hold a hard one? I mean, baby, do you know the game? I mean, baby, do you know the game? I'm a big league pitcher. Can you catch the hurl I'm playing? Can you hit?
Thank you.
If I pitch, can you catch? Will you hold the ball? When you step to the plate, will you swing and fall? Baseball Boogie by Mabel Scott on Theme Time Radio Hour. In the 50s, every red-blooded American boy either wanted to play baseball or be Elvis Presley. Here's a rockabilly song by Chauncey Holiday that combines the best of both worlds. Gonna knock the cover right off the ball. That was Chauncey Holiday stepping up to the plate, getting a grand slam, sweeping you off your feet, scoring a home run with you, and with me too. Home run on Theme Time Radio Hour. I caught up with Charlie Sheen at the car wash. He's a big baseball fan, and he's got a lot of opinions about the game.
Baseball to me represents life. It's about heroes and goats. It's about failure and success. It's about individual effort. It's about team effort. Baseball is about the game within the game. It's really the only major sport that is not governed by time. And the thing that makes me insane is people that say, well, baseball's boring. There's just two guys playing catch. They don't understand the game within the game. They don't understand that the how much changes from pitch to pitch. It's actually fractions of a second that a guy has to make a decision that he's actually going to swing and then either put it somewhere between one and nine guys or hit it over the fence.
1-1 to Williams. One out, nobody on, last of the eighth inning. Jack Fisher into his windup. Here's the pitch. Williams swings, and there's a long drive to deep right. That ball is going, and it is gone. A home run for Ted Williams in his last time at bat in the major league.
Uh-huh.
Johnny Darling and Fast Tempo Doo-Wop from the King record label, doing a song about a baseball baby. Next we have a baseball canto by Lawrence Ferlin Getty, the well-known poet who lived in San Francisco. He started the City Lights Bookstore. His publication of Allen Ginsberg's Howl in 1956 led to his arrest on obscenity charges. He was a brave man and a brave poet. Watching baseball, sitting in the sun, eating popcorn, reading Ezra Pound, and wishing that Juan Marichal would hit a hole right through the Anglo-Saxon tradition in the first canto and demolish the barbarian invaders. Well, why don't I let Larry say the rest of it? Lawrence Ferlinghetti, Baseball Canto.
It's the World Series. And this is a former World Series team. Baseball Canto. Watching baseball, sitting in the sun, eating popcorn, reading Ezra Pound. And wishing Juan Marichal would hit a hole right through the Anglo-Saxon tradition in the first canto. And demolish the barbarian invaders from Los Angeles. When the San Francisco Giants take the field and everybody stands up to the national anthem with some Irish tenor's voice piped over the loudspeakers with all the players struck dead in their places and the white umpires like Irish cops in their black suits and little black caps pressed over their hearts standing straight and still like at some funeral of a Blarney bartender. And all facing east as if expecting some great white hope or the Founding Fathers to appear on the horizon. But Willie Mays appears instead in the bottom of the first, and a roar goes up as he clouts the first one into the sun and takes off like a foot runner from Thebes. The ball is lost in the sun and maidens wail after him, but he keeps running through the Anglo-Saxon epic. And Tito Fuentes comes up looking like a bullfighter in his tight pants and small pointed shoes, and the right field bleachers go mad with Chicanos and blacks and Brooklyn beer drinkers. Sweet Tito, sock it to him, sweet Tito. And sweet Tito puts his foot in the bucket and smacks one that don't come back at all and flees around the bases like he's escaping from the United Fruit Company. As the gringo dollar beats out the pound, and sweet Tito beats it out like he's beating out usury, not to mention fascism and anti-Semitism. And Juan Marichal comes up, and the Chicano bleachers go loco again as Juan belts the first fastball out of sight and rounds first and keeps going and rounds second and rounds third and keeps going and hits pay dirt to the roars of the grungy populace as some nut presses the backstage panic button for the tape-recorded national anthem again to save the situation. But it don't stop nobody this time in their revolution round the loaded white bases. In this last of the great Anglo-Saxon epics in the Territorio Libre of baseball.
That was Lawrence Ferlinghetti on Theme Time Radio Hour, where we're talking baseball. Here's Cowboy Copas, a honky-tonk singer from the late 40s. He was making a comeback in the early 60s when he died in the same air crash that killed Patsy Cline and Hawkshaw Hawkins. Three strikes and you're out. Here he's talking about love being like a game where if you don't win, you can pout. You can make three strikes and then you're out. Cowboy Copas.
Now love is like a game, my darling. If you don't win, you always pout. Just like the game, the rules are the same. You can make three strikes and then you're out. That's all there is to the game, dear. If you cheat, the umpire throws you out. You cheated and you lied, you were never satisfied. You made three strikes and now you're out. strike you made was when you cheated. The second strike was made when you walked out. The third strike was when you got your freedom. That makes three strikes and now you're out. That's all there is to the game, dear. If you cheat, the umpire throws you out. You cheated and you lied, you were never satisfied. You made three strikes and now you're out. Now that our little game is over, don't ever let me hear you shout that I was untrue or pitched a curve to you. You made three strikes and now you're out. That's all there is to the game, dear. If you cheat, the umpire throws you out. You cheated and you lied, you were never satisfied. You made three strikes and now you're out. You cheated and you lied, you were never satisfied. You made three strikes and now you're out.
That was Cowboy Copas. You make three strikes and you're out. If you cheat, the umpire calls you out. If diamonds are a girl's best friend, why do so many girls get mad when you want to go to the ballpark? You tell me. Sister Winona Carr was a powerful gospel singer. She also recorded some rhythm and blues numbers. Her best known number, however, is a gospel song, and it's all about the game of baseball.
At the home plate, he's waiting for you there.
to one own a car, talking about life being a ball game.
Where every day life is a ball game, and everybody can play. Jesus is at the home plate, and at the first base is temptation, second base is sin, third base is tribulation, and King Solomon is the umpire. Satan was on always waiting to psych you out, and Daniel's up at bat. Satan pitches a fastball, and Job hits a home run, and you got to just swing at the ball, give it your all. Moses is on the sidelines. He's waiting to be called. Sister Winona Carr, the ball game.
All right, next we have Buddy Johnson with his Jump Blues song, Did You See Jackie Robinson Hit That Ball? He's talking in this song about Satchel Paige and Roy Campanella, Don Newcomb, and Larry Doby too. Singing about, yes, boy, yes, Jackie can hit that ball. Did you see Jackie Robinson hit that ball? I don't know, I wasn't there, but I sure feel like I was.
Jackie hits that ball.
When he swung his bat, the crowd went wild, because he knocked that ball a solid mile. Yeah, boy.
Yes, yes, Jackie hits that ball. Satchel Paige is mellow, so is Campanella, Newcomb and Doby too. But it's a natural fact, when Jackie comes to bat, the other team is through. Boy,
did you see Jackie Robinson hit that ball? Did he hit it? Boy, and that ain't all. It's so old.
Yes, yes, Jack is real gone. Satchel Paige is mellow, so is Campanella, Newcomb and Doby too. But it's a natural fact, when Jackie comes to bat, the other team is through. Boy,
did you see Jackie Robinson hit that ball? Did he hit it? Boy, and that ain't all, he's so old.
Yes, yes, Jackie is real gone. Jackie is a real gone guy.
One of the greatest ball players ever. The man who broke the color line in the major leagues. Did you see Jackie Robinson hit that ball? You know, Abbott and Costello said that a lot of baseball players have funny names.
All I'm trying to find out is what's the guy's name on first base?
Well, he's on second base.
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who's on first?
I don't know.
He's
third base. I know that.
But they also have funny nicknames. Ted Williams was known as the Splendid Splinter. Babe Ruth, the Sultan of SWAT. Ty Cobb was known as the Old Georgia Peach. Let's not forget Mordecai Three Fingers Brown and the Yankee Clipper, Jolton Joe DiMaggio. And while we're on the subject of Jolton Joe, let's hear a song about him featuring Les Brown and his band of renown. And Jolton Joe makes a little guest appearance himself.
No.
We need a hit, so here I go.
Ball one.
Yay!
Ball two.
Yay!
Strike one.
Ooh!
Strike two.
Kill that umpire.
Yay!
A case of Wheaties.
Thank you.
man and not a free. Jolting Joe DiMaggio.
Joe, Joe DiMaggio, we want you and I.
He tied the mark at 44, July the 1st, you know. Since then he's hit a good 12 more, Jolting Joe DiMaggio.
Joe, Joe DiMaggio, we want you on our side.
From coast to coast, that's all you'll hear of Joe, the one-man show. He's glorified the horsehide sphere, Jolting Joe DiMaggio.
Joe, Joe DiMaggio, we want you on our side.
He'll live in baseball's Hall of Fame. He got there blow by blow. Our kids will tell their kids his name, Jolting Joe DiMaggio.
We dream of Joey with the light from back. Joe, Joe DiMaggio,
we want you on our side. Whispers low of how they stopped our Joe. One night in Cleveland, oh, 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 goodbye Street DiMaggio.
Here's another song about Jolting Joe by Billy Bragg and Wilco from the album Mermaid Avenue, where they take the unfinished lyrics of Woody Guthrie and add music to them.
Woody Guthrie, of course, was the dean of American folk artists. At the time of his death, in 1967, Guthrie left behind some 2,500 unfinished songs. The lyrics about New York streets, film star idols, drinking, loving, dying, and even spaceships were specifically chosen because they presented a completely different aspect to Woody's public persona.
Here's a song that Woody wrote about Jolting Joe, the Yankee Clipper.
Joe's done it again. Some folks thought Big Joe was done. Some just figured Joe was gone. Steps to the batter with a great big grin. Jody Maggio's done it again. I'm gonna tell you just the way I feel. Man can't run without his heel. Watch that raggy Bill spit the wind. Joe's done it again. All three fielders jump their best, trying to climb that apple fence. They all grow whiskers on their chin. Joe Maggio's done it again. Up along the clouds where the eagles roam, Joe cracked that ball to whine and roam. His buddies all that fast, they tried on in. Joe DiMaggio's done it again. Grandma's on by the radio, on the television watching Joe. She jerks the beard off a grandpa's chin. Joe DiMaggio's done it again. Bumpy dog barked at the Blues-Eye Cat. How does it look from where you sit? Looks like a cyclone sliding in. Joe DiMaggio's done it again.
Billy Bragg and Wilco singing their song about Joe DiMaggio and Grandma, who's listening to the Yankees home by the radio. We're on the radio too, theme time radio. But I guess you already knew that, because you're listening. All We heard about Jackie Robinson earlier. This song here is about Don Newcomb. Don Newcomb really throws that ball. He winds up and throws it. He was a 6'4", 225-pound fireball thrower. The only baseball player to have won Rookie of the Year 3 times in a row.
When Don winds up and throws that ball, that's when you hear the umpire call.
Strike one. Strike one.
Don Newcomb really throws that ball. Don Newcomb really throws that ball. When Roy Campanella gives him the sign, you can see that ball coming down the line.
Strike two. Strike two.
The bases are loaded, 2 men out. The count is 3-2. But my man Nuke just plays it cool, 'cause he knows just what to do. Now Newcomb really throws that ball. Don Newcomb really throws that ball. His fastball shoots across the plate. The batter swings, but he's way too late.
Strike three. You're out.
Sonny Rollins used to have the nickname Nuke because everyone thought he looked like Don Newcomb. Here's tenor saxophonist Sonny Rollins with his song Nuke's Fadeaway. Thank you.
get it going. Sonny Rollins with his big league sound, covering all of the bases. Luke's Fade Away. All right, Cliff and Claude Trenier were twin brothers who sang with a bunch of big bands but branched out to rock and roll. Here they have a special guest with them by the name of Willie Mays on their song Say Hey from the OK Record label, the Treniers.
What do you mean, go get it? Man, that ball's way in left field.
I don't care what field it's in. Willie plays all fields.
Every time we come to the game, you're talking about Willie plays all the fields.
That's right.
Let's call Willie and ask him. Call him.
Okay. Hey, Willie.
Yes.
Are you Willie Mays?
Yes.
Whose ball was that?
Why was it?
In left field.
Well, that's Irvin's ball.
I told you that. Every time we come to the game, we got to talk about it. The next time, I'm going to sit in the grandstand.
Say, hey, fellas, what's your name?
Say who?
Say Willie. Say hey.
Say who?
Swinging at the plate. Say hey.
Say who?
Say Willie. That giant hit is great. When he hits the ball, it's long gone, man. Hits it farther than camp began. Swings the bat like a little lead pipe. When they reach the ball, it's overripe. Say hey.
Say who?
Say Willie. Say hey.
Say who?
Swinging at the plate. Say hey.
A choo-choo train swings around second like an aeroplane. His cap flies off when it passes third, and he heads home like an eagle bird.
Say hey,
say who,
say Willie, say hey,
say who,
swinging at the plate. Say hey,
say who,
say Willie, that giant kid is great. Yes, he covers center like he had jet shoes. The other batters get the Willie blues. Anything hit his way is out. Man, it just don't pay those guys to clout. Say hey,
say who,
say Willie, say hey,
say who,
swinging at the plate. Say hey,
say who,
say Willie, that giant kid is great.
Giants in an awful jam, but now he's back and he's Leo's joy, and Willie's still a growing boy.
Say hey,
say who,
say Willie, say hey,
say who,
drinking at the plate. Say hey,
say who,
say Willie, that giant kid is great. That giant kid is great. Say Willie, what you gonna say?
Brought this crowd to its feet with a catch which must have been an optical illusion to a lot of people. Boy.
Let's check out the email basket. I hope they don't throw us a curve. Today's email is from Jamie Christensen of Las Vegas, Nevada. She writes, "Dear Theme Time, I enjoy listening to the ball games late at night. My boyfriend says the radio keeps them up. What should I do?" Well, Jamie, you should do what I used to do. When I was supposed to be asleep, I'd take the bedside radio and slip it under my pillow. Press your ear close to the pillow, which is what you're supposed to do with pillows anyway,
and listen to the second game of the doubleheader without bothering anybody else in the house. Millions upon millions used to do the same thing back when radio was king. And I hope you still do that with Theme Time Radio Hour, your private pillow pal. Thanks for your letter. Press your ear up close to the pillow, Jamie.
Hey, Ozzy!
After Christmas in 54, the greatest shortstop to ever play was born. A fleet-footed switch hitting acrobat feet. The Wizard of Oz, there's no doubt about that.
Hey, Ozzy!
Catch that ball.
Hey, Ozzy!
You're the best of all. Osborne Earl, now that's his name. Brought a brand new level to the game.
Hey,
Cardinals knew they got a special gift when he took the field with his backflip, diving left to right, soaring up and down on the yellow brick road to Cooperstown.
Hey, Ozzy!
Yeah, catch that ball.
Hey, Ozzy!
You're the best of all. The Wizard of Oz, now that's his name. He's going to the Hall of Fame.
Hey, Ozzy!
Feeling he learned to hit in the 85 playoffs, gave the Dodgers a fit. But sort of thought this was just a hoax till Jack Buck said, "Go crazy, folks."
Hey,
playoff MVP.
Hey,
he can bunt or he can take you deep. Try going up the middle, he'll make you pay by turning your hit into a double play. Fresh Enos, Red and Dizzy, Stan the Man, Luke Brock and Gibby. They're making his flac and etching his face so the Wizard of Oz can take his place.
Hey, Ozzy!
He's number one with love.
Hey, Ozzy!
He's got 13 gold gloves. He played in 15 All-Star games. He's going to the Hall of Fame.
Hey, Ozzy!
The Wizard of Oz, Osborne Earl, that's his name, brought a whole new level to the game. That was Sam Bush. Sam is a great fiddle and mandolin player, a big session man over there in Nashville, and he's a big baseball fan. We're talking about Ozzy. No, not that Ozzy. We're talking about the Wizard of Oz, the MVP, Osborne Earl Smith. He was elected to the Baseball Hall of Fame in 2002. In 2003... he was inducted into the St. Louis Walk of Fame, and this year, he was played on Theme Time Radio Hour. Let's take a seventh inning stretch.
Oh, stretch, stretch, it's the seventh inning stretch. Good to stretch a little bit, so relaxing you'll admit. Best of all, it means refreshment time is here, so we'll sing out for Falstaff beer.
Third base, Dodger Stadium, comes from the Rye Cooter album called Chavez Ravine, which tells the story of how thousands of poor Mexicans were forced out of what they called the poor man's Shangri-La to make way for Dodger Stadium. I work here, parking cars, under the moon and stars, the same ones that we all knew back in 1952. Everyone wants to know where a local boy like me is coming from. Third base, Dodger Stadium.
Baseball man, as anyone can plainly see, Brady's game in his great land. Take a little tip from me. I work in nights, parking cars, underneath the moon and stars. that we all knew back in 1952. And if you want to know where a local boy like me is coming from, third base, Dodgers Stadium. Second base, right over there. I see Grandma in a rocking chair, watching linens flapping.
Ryan Cooter and a whole lot of other good folks helping him out on that record. Third base, Dodger Stadium. This song tells a little bit of the story. To hear the whole story, listen to the album, Chavez Ravine. All right, this is Theme Time Radio Hour. We're getting ready to head into extra innings, so we got time for one more song. This is a song from the play Damn Yankees. I don't mean the band that Ted Nugent is in with those guys from Styx.
Damn Yankees is a musical comedy, a modern retelling of the Faust legend set in Washington, D.C. It opened on Broadway in 1955, starring Gwen Verdon and Ray Walston. In baseball, like all of life, you got to have heart. You got to have hope. Mustn't sit around and mope. Nothing half as bad as it may appear. Wait till next year and hope. When your luck is batting zero, get your chin up off the floor. Mister, you can be a hero. You can open any door.
Now listen to me, you guys. This game of baseball is only one half skill. The other half is something else. Something bigger. You gotta have heart. All you really need is heart. When the odds are saying you'll never win, that's when the grin should start. You gotta have hope. Mustn't sit around and mope. Nothing's half as bad as it may appear. Wait till next year and hope. When your luck is batting zero, get your chin up off the floor. Mister, you can be a hero. You can open any door. There's nothing to it but to do it. You gotta have heart. Miles and miles and miles of heart. Oh, it's fine to be a genius, of course, but keep that old horse before the cart. First, you gotta have heart.
A great slugger we haven't got.
A great pitcher we haven't got.
A great ball club we haven't got.
What do we got? We've got heart. All you really need is heart. When the odds are saying you'll never win, that's when the grin should start.
Now you're getting the idea.
We've got hope. We don't sit around and mope. Not a solitary sod do we heed, mister, 'cause we've got hope.
Boys, I'm proud of you.
We're so happy that we're humming.
That's the hearty thing to do.
Ho, ho, ho.
'Cause we know our ship will come in.
So it's 10 years overdue.
Ho, ho, ho. We've got heart, miles and miles and miles of heart. Oh, it's fine to be a genius, of course, but keep that old horse before the cart.
So what the heck's the use of crying?
Why should we case?
We gotta get better, 'cause we can't get worse. And to add to it,
we've got heart.
Top of the ninth, one away, nobody on. The Senators now just two outs away from the pennant. Bauer steps in. Hollingsworth gets his sign, delivers, Bauer swings, and it's a hard hit ball to deep short. So Hovick charges over, backhands it beautifully, and there's the long throw, and he's out by a step.
Here comes Gloria Thorpe. Tell it to her.
Go ahead, Rocky. You start.
Yeah, go ahead.
We've got heart. All you really need is heart. When the odds are saying you'll never win, that's when the grin should start.
We're so happy that we're laughing.
Ha, ha, ha.
That's the hearty thing to do.
Ho, ho, ho.
So we ain't been autographing.
Ha, ha, ha.
Except to sign an IOU.
Ho, ho, ho. We've got heart. Miles and miles and miles of heart. Oh, it's fine to be a genius, of course, but keep that old horse before the cart.
Who minds them
pop bottles flying.
The hisses and boos.
The team has been consistent.
Yeah, we always lose, but we're laughing 'cause we've got heart.
Got to have heart. Got to have a lot of things. Got to have something on the brain. Got to have correct postage. Got to have a dog you can trust. Got to have a dry hat and your lawyer's phone number. Got to have your girlfriend's credit card. You got to have it all together. Got to have room to move. You got to have what it takes. You got to have a hot meal and a warm place to sleep. You got to have heart. From the original soundtrack of Damn Yankees. Well, that's it for another show. I'm going to head back to the dugout, see if I can find myself a relief pitcher. See you again next week on Theme Time Radio Hour, the field of dreams, schemes, and themes.